are, you know? I wasn't aware I needed rescuing. But okay, I suppose you do. Ah, that's the word, isn't it? A dashing prince for us ladies to swoon over and then fight over. I think we should prefer our men less dashing, as they dash off to the next girl while we are busy pulling our hair. Maybe. I'd grown quite fond of it. The iron bars, the pattern of squares, and... Well, I guess that's it. But I do like squares. Imagine a vast field of pure white, soft as a pillow wrapped in a cloud. From a distance, you might think it's snow. Yet, when you come to the lip of its feathery shore and run your fingers through crowns of ivory, you'll know you have arrived in Whiterun. Home of Tamriel's most beautiful and profitable tundra cotton field. Zora's field, as it's known to the locals. The scars came from adventuring. Most of them are barely visible, thanks to the one. From a distance, it may appear to be a dash of paint, a girl's attempt to look menacing. Upon closer inspection, you'll see it's a mark of a burn. When I was a flowering young maiden, I once had many suitors. Men would travel great distances to see the diamond of Riverwood. My sister, on the other hand, had no suitors to speak of. She was far more talented than I, a mage worthy of studying at the College of Winterhold. What she was not, unfortunately, was pretty. We'd fight often, about the smallest of things. Although they were never really about who was supposed to wash the clothes or sweep the floor. It was always about her envy and my lack of compassion. Eventually, one argument got rough. The hand she struck me with was cloaked in fire. No, I deserved it. Not the flames, but the slap. Make no mistake, I was a real bitch. Beauty tends to make monsters of us all. She didn't intend to burn me, of course, no. Just all of that anger, that rage, manifested itself into fire. Now, but not then. Oh no, I was sufficiently devastated. My beauty was all they had. It defined me. But it was the ugliness that hurt the most. The way people, not just men, looked at me. Always with that cringe. They all do it. Even the polite ones can't help themselves, no matter how hard they try to disguise it. When you're beautiful, every word is met with a smile. When it's gone, the whole world is shrouded in darkness. I couldn't loathe my sister for what she did. Not now that I know her pain. She sends a letter every now and then, just to let me know she's alive. She can take care of herself, but that does not mean I don't worry. Oh, I think she moves around. She can't really live in a city. She's kind of a witch. As for her last letter, well, that has also been a very long time. Too long, which makes me worry. We should stop by the Sleeping Giant Inn. Maybe someone has heard something. What do you mean? What crystal?
My, you're stupid. And ugly. The crystal is the property I was referring to earlier.
This is not the time for petty insults, witch. How did she escape into a crystal?
Young people, so impatient. The crystal is a key, a portal to another plane of existence. The legends say it would transport you to a paradise of eternal youth. Naturally, for someone of my years, this seemed like an attractive prospect. The devil is in the wording, of course. Eternal youth, indeed. It's a curse. Anyone who enters the plane turns into a child of body, and a child of mind. God knows I warned the stupid girl, but young people just do not listen.
In any case, the only way to revive the crystal's power is to remove the soul inside it. Thus, our goals are one and the same.
Young people are idiots. Children even more so. Maybe that's what makes the crystal so appealing. They say ignorance is bliss. Well, guess what? It also means you're ignorant. You two want to say any last words to each other before we do this? Well, too bad. In you go.
By the gods. Jocelyn?
Welcome to Zor's Field, sister.
Sister, you made this for me?
Remember that time Mother said it was too warm to go sledding? And I cried, and you cried. And then Father got the idea to throw cotton all over the house instead. Then you said we should plant cotton all over the tundra so that we never have a day without snow.
I remember, sister. Every day.
Well, here we are, Zora. This is our home. We never have to leave. We never have to cry.
Jocelyn, I...
Come on, sister. Let's go play.
It all seems so foolish now when Skyrim is so cold. The truth is I never really cared much for snow. I love bright colors. I only pouted because it meant so much to her. And maybe a part of me wanted to be that sister again. The one who pretended to care about nothing, to protect the things that meant everything. That day we met, I lied to you. I was on my way to the tundra, but it wasn't for Zora's field. It was always for Jocelyn. Now I know why she joined that coven. It was all for this. She wanted to be a child again. She wanted that feeling of home, but in a place where all the bad memories don't exist. Somewhere far away from Riverwood. I know, as much as it hurts me to say this, none of this is real. Just give me a moment to talk to her.
Do you see it, sister? Do you see the snow?
Jocelyn, dear. I know at times I've been a bad sister. I should have been there for you when all I cared about was myself. And I know you're sorry for what happened that day. This field, this place. You want to go back to those days when all our memories were beautiful. But sister, we can't. As much as we treasure them, those days are gone. So is every day we grew apart. I love you, Jocelyn. Please come home.
No! I'm not leaving! You aren't leaving! You're not my real sister. You're someone else.
He'll pay. Jocelyn!
Zora?
Don't worry, sister. I'm here.
I'm so sorry.
Don't be.
Give me a moment. I can take us home. Our real home.
All right, when you're ready. I just want to thank you. I know I tease you, calling you my liege and my thane, but on this day you were all that and more. You were not just my companion, my savior, and my hero. You were a true friend. My princess is very kind. Now I have two sisters whom I love and will always cherish.